The cooperative is a very big story in India. Why? Because that is the promotion of actual entrepreneurship. Now, the KVIC is basically about the Khadi Village Industry Scheme, and the social objective for them is to provide employment. Does not require any high-end machinery. Khadi does not require any sort of external technology. Good morning and welcome to session 6 in unit 4, Entrepreneurship and Small Business Management, where we are going to talk about the KVIC. Now, the KVIC is basically about the Khadi Village Industry Scheme, and the social objective for them is to provide employment. So KVIC is a very, very big organization whose primary objective is to provide employment, and they also produce saleable articles. The wider objective of this is to build reliance among the poor and building up a stronger rural community spirit. Now, we as Indians have definitely need to be proud about the factors that we were the promoter of Khadi related products in this world. There can be, you know, a situation which cannot be as proud as this, saying that we are the founders of the Khadi movement altogether. Even now, in every corner of the world, the Khadi and Khadi related products have a distinctive mark for themselves. So with that, let me go into the KVIC's activity. Now, the functions are something like this. They plan, they promote, they organize and implement programs for the development of Khadi and other village industries in the rural sector. Our father of nation, Mahatma Gandhi, said that the heart of India, the pulse of India, lies in the rural sector. So that's exactly what the Khadi Village Industry Scheme is all about. What they wanted to do is that they wanted to promote the rural sector in India. The one way, with a less investment and a greater promotion, a greater appreciation in the market, is definitely Khadi. Khadi does not require any high-end machinery. Khadi does not require any sort of external technology. It only requires a basic manpower and that setting up of the, you know, human resources factor, which could help them to promote this industry to the next level as far as possible. So the Khadi Village Industry Center primarily try to coordinate, plan, and they try to implement the programs that are necessary for that. Now, the KVIC also will try to promote food products. They will also try to promote leather products. They will try to promote factors like, you know, the clothing material, art and handicrafts, and other factors altogether. Now, the biggest challenge for them, what I have always felt, is that KVIC is never ever marketed like that of other textile or other garments. Now, for example, when we talk about those big brands like Louis Philippe or an Allen Solly, or when we talk about Van Hoosen and Raymond's and all these names, these are probably well-known domestic names in the sector because of the marketing, because of the promotional activities that go in. But when you talk about a Khadi primarily, this kind of material still requires a lot of promotion and awareness among our people. People still look at it as only as an occasional use, or people think that that's not something which could be worn to the office or to the places on a regular basis. So that's where the usage value, the promotional value, starts declining to a great extent. So KVIC today is trying to promote this all together with the help of the rural entrepreneurs, trying to promote this to the maximum area, to the maximum limits altogether. And they have been doing a fantastic job in terms of engaging with the rural youth at any given point of time. Followed by, its functions will also compromise of the building of reserve of raw materials, implements for supply of producers, creation of common service facility, processing of raw materials, semi-furnished good, and the facilities of the marketing also. KBIC has also understood this factor that in order to promote a full-fledged industry like Khadi, you need to set up the entire chain, that is starting from the inventory to that of the finished goods to that of the final chain link altogether. We need to create a whole lot of repository factors there. And if you're not able to create that chain, if you're not able to pull yourself along that line, then you will not be able to support this industry. So what typically they have done is that they have created a complete supply chain, starting from the raw materials, the inventory to that of finished goods altogether, and they have been able to set up small franchisee stores in every district and every rural part of India. So wherever you go to the towns and cities and district centers in our country, you will definitely be able to see a Khadi shop which tries to promote the Khadi products altogether. Now, KBI products, apart from the organization of training of artisans, they are engaged in industries and encouragement of cooperative efforts. The cooperative is a very big story in India. Why? Because that is the promotion of actual entrepreneurship. When you talk about a fisherman cooperative, or when you talk about a Mahila Sahakari cooperative, or you talk about a farmers cooperative, weavers cooperative, these are all been the hubs of promoting entrepreneurship at various level, at various stand altogether. Now, what is happening here is that whenever you look into this word called as cooperative, the very moment, the very instance, they are basically trying to join hands to create a small effort into a larger ones. They are basically like a self-help group which indicate and instigate the concept of financing among themselves, do a small level marketing, help you to set up a small show altogether, and then start promoting employment among themselves. Now, most of the districts in India have been successful in creating some or other cooperatives, but the only factor, the only change, the only importance that comes into picture is that will have been they engaged 100% kind of an employment activity, 100% generation altogether has always been a challenge, has always been a question that people are trying to understand, that people are trying to look after. But nevertheless, KBIC has always been a very important success story for all of us to learn. Followed by the headquarters of KBIC is located in New Delhi, and there are 6 zonal offices which are spread across India, starting with New Delhi, Bhopal, Bangalore, Kolkata, Mumbai, and Guwahati. So they are there in the northeast, west, and south, with Guwahati also coming into picture. So you can now see that KBIC's ideology was to have a zonal office spread with different branch offices. They have 29 more branches in various parts of India which are trying to join hands together, and they are promoting the business to the next level as far as possible. So definitely you would see that the importance of KBIC is building up at all levels possible. Now, the KBIC scheme details. What are the KBIC scheme details? They are listed in terms of aiming to achieve the objectives set for the commission. KBIC as a commission has got a list of objectives which are entitled, which are promoted specially in order to help the rural sector, in order to promote a complete entrepreneurship push altogether. So when we see that, the first one is definitely the Prime Minister, the Rural Employment Generation Program, which is coming up with the Pradhan Mantri Rozgar Yojana. And this is coming up basically like a credit link subsidy program aimed at creating employment opportunities across all parts of the country. So that concept of credit link account activity is actually gathering a lot of steam. Let me tell you why. Because whenever you look into entrepreneurship, the credibility of your business is always given with the help of the financial support. So once the financial support starts ramping up altogether in your particular area, in your particular district, then automatically every youth will be able to see the success story and they will also join the bandwagon of starting up this business. So somewhere down the lane, the Prime Minister's Employment Guarantee Program has been really successful with that credit linking facility, trying to promote a host lot of entrepreneurship activities, followed by the interest subsidy eligibility certificate. So it has been designed to be a major source of KVIC projects. It is helping to mobilize funds from banking institutions to bridge funding about the gap in budgetary allocation. So definitely this is a major step that has been taken. Why? Because if you look into the factors, most of the rural sectors are denied by the banking institution, and there are very, very few banks in India which are dedicated for the rural economy. Most of the banks still feel that it is only in the metro and tier 2 cities where the growth is possible. So they tend to concentrate again on personal loan, educational loan, home loan, and probably all other kinds of loan which are more significant to the rural, to the urban India. But here, if you start looking into KVIC, they have started looking in for the mobilization of funds with the bank, and they have been able to promote the rural economy. And the other thing which I would like to talk about is the scheme of fund of regeneration of the traditional industry, what we call as the FURTI altogether. This is basically to promote a cluster development involving Khadi village products. So when I use that word cluster, it's a very big joint effort that is being taken, and the nodal agency again is KVIC. So they take the responsibility of promoting a business in terms of a cooperative, in terms of a cluster, and they start seeing that the business is being pushed to the next level as far as possible. The next thing is the marketing promotion development assistance. If you see that, they have been able to give the assistance in terms of income, artisans 40%, producers will get 40%, and the sellers get 20%. So objectively, the money is given more to the person who produces, who puts in the effort to create the product, rather than just the seller. They do not want to come into a broker business. They don't want to become a commission agency. Rather, they want to be people who can promote the business to the person who owns it. So definitely the creators of the business should be benefited, and KVIC stands for it. With this, I come to the end of this particular session. I hope and believe that all the information that has been shared through this particular session would be of a great value and resource to you. In the upcoming sessions, we shall talk more about the different aspects of entrepreneurship. But until then, stay tuned, stay blessed, and stay enlightened forever. Thank you once again for joining me today on this wonderful session.